So while trailers normally debut at 9 or 10 a.m., sometimes 8 a.m. if you're Disney and you want that Good Morning America synergy, this one debuted at 3 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. Why did Disney do that? That's because they wanted to, I think quite commendably, prioritize the British Isles time zone-wise, and that was 8 a.m. Across the pond. And that's because Artemis Fowl is an Irish character. Now, the James Bond franchise does this all the time, prioritizing the UK, because that's also a character from the same region. But it's unusual for Disney to favor a smaller market. No offense, guys, but your box office, the UK box office is strong, but it's not the same level as the United States, China, and sometimes even countries like, well, I think the UK is on par with like Russia, Mexico, the UK's in there, sometimes Australia, but it's not one of the bigger movie markets. But I think that's wonderful that Disney is honoring Artemis Fowl's heritage. In fact, they went out of their way to cast an Irish actor in the lead role to double down on that. Now on paper, I've been looking into this because I knew the trailer was coming out, this series seems very derivative. A little Harry Potter, a little Despicable Me, a little Chronicles of Narnia. Let's see if Kenny Branagh can make it seem like its own thing. Here we go.
Our world has never been in more danger. Human greed is what drove us underground all those years ago.
No, we're not that bad.
To escape from your rapacious appetite. I warn you, boy.
I'm hoping he's like a little Damian Wayne.
You are not prepared for the truth behind what you seek.
You spend that money, Disney? Kind of Bond-like music there.
Now you will believe. Artemis Fowl.
That's a I don't think that it gave me a feeling of like, oh, I'd love to enter that world myself. Instead, I was like, you know, is that Judi Dench? That's awesome. Speaking of Bond. But I just feel like, you know, it doesn't seem that fresh to me, I guess. And I feel really bad criticizing a child actor, but maybe when he speaks, but he did not pop off the screen to me, this choice for Artemis Fowl. It wasn't like, who's that kid? Instead, I was like, yeah. I saw some online comments when I was getting this trailer. Some people were saying it looked a little like a Disney Channel movie. It looks to me like a cross between a Disney Channel movie and those movies that don't quite hit their mark, like Dark Tower, in terms of the lack of color. I think when they're like, oh, it's like, it's fantasy, but like it's real. I think when you try and sometimes that's a very hard, you know, mix to do. Doctor Strange is a movie that I think that did that very well. Kudos again to Scott Derrickson. Where's our Doctor Strange 2 announcement? I think they're waiting until after Avengers 4. But anyway, you know, Dark Tower, I think, is a great example where that did not work. And this, to me, seems like, it's like, why do you want it to be rooted in reality? I would just love, the idea is like a fairy James Bond villain type idea, according to the author. But I'm not seeing Bond movies are a little brighter than this. I guess what I'm saying is I don't think Kenneth Branagh should ever direct a James Bond movie. But what do you, and that little, and you know, James Bond villains are so charismatic. And again, I'm not sensing it from that child actor just yet. I'm going to give him the benefit of the doubt because he's a kid. All right, so what do you think? Write your thoughts down below, particularly if you're a fan of the series. What do you think of it come to life? Again, share those thoughts down below. And of course, as always, you can check out some more videos right now.